Yeah.
Yeah.
That's my formal education. Yeah. And but I never did it because I finished school and I knew this was not what I was going to do with my life. I didn't think I could be very good at that. It wasn't. I needed the more immediate satisfaction. And when you are a designer, it can take 5 years until you see something that you put on paper in real life. So I didn't have the patience for it. And about less than a year after I finished school, art school, my mother was one of the three mothers of ceramics in Israel. There were three ladies from Germany who came from Germany and started ceramics in Israel. They were teaching and so on and so forth. And she broke her hip. Was on crutches. And she had an exhibition that was planned 3 years before. But obviously she started to work the last 6 months. And she was on crutches. So I came to, she had an exhibition in Hamburg, in a museum in Hamburg. And I came to help her. I was her legs. She was sitting on the wheel, I took the things from her, I brought the things to her, I prepared the clay, and I was 25 years old, and it was the first time in my life I asked a question about ceramics, because before I tried to get away from it. And when she went to Germany for the exhibition, both my parents went to Germany for our exhibition, I was in a very, it was my, the most difficult year in my life because I only knew what I didn't want to do. I had no idea what I did want to do. So during that summer when they were in Germany, I decided that I had to try it. And once I tried it, I got hooked. And that's it. All the rest is history. It was a very natural development from the single pieces that I have been doing in recent years. And I was once asked to give a slideshow of my work. And the headline that I gave it, in Hebrew, it is like a game of words, but in English too, from containers to a containing environment. Because the beginning of every potter is containers, whether it's a container for coffee or for whatever. And then it becomes, as a very good friend of mine once said, he's a very good ceramist, big name, Marek Tetzula. He started to do non-functional things. And people kept asking him,